So I want to try to do some inlay carving, and I want to carve this yin-yang shape onto this piece of wood, and the inlay that I want to use is this darker piece of oak. And I'm going to use my router pantograph set to 1/3 scale, so to get this size of yin-yang, I need a template that's 3 times this size. And I'm going to make this template out of just a piece of cardboard that I'm going to glue down on some piece of hardboard, so I don't even need to use wood for my template. With a 3x scale, hopefully the cardboard will be accurate enough. I need that circle that goes in the middle of the yin-yang to be in exactly the right place, so I'm using the part that I just cut out to help position that circle exactly where it needs to go. If it's not in the right place, the inlay that I'm going to carve is just not going to fit. I'm using the part that I cut out of my positive template to make another negative template, which I'll later use to shape the part that I'll actually inlay into the cavity that I'm going to carve. Now here's checking the geometry to figure out where I need to position the stock so that this yin-yang will be cut in the center of it. I need to make a cylindrical follower that's exactly 3x the size of my router bit, and just putting a piece of wood on the piece of rod and holding that against the belt sander does a really nice job of shaping a nice and accurate cylinder. So here's my routed out cavity. Now I need to make an inlay that fits exactly into there. So now using my reverse template, which is made out of the pieces I cut out of my first template, I'm going to carve out the exact opposite of that shape to mate with the cavity that I just cut. So here I cut the outline of my inlay. Next I'm using the bandsaw to cut this inlay piece off of its backing, so I can actually inlay it into the piece of wood. Now I'm removing the burrs from the edges and then cleaning out some of the rough spots that I missed on the bottom. Now I couldn't route all the way into the corner of the tail, so here I'm marking the outline of the actual tail, and then I chisel that out by hand. Now here's gluing it in, and it turned out to be a much tighter fit than I had anticipated, so I had to take some persuasive measures. Now just rubbing some glue and sawdust onto the edges, which does a pretty good job of hiding some of the imperfections. And now sanding everything flush. So the contrast of the two woods doesn't show up as strongly as I was hoping for. But a little bit of varnish on the surface usually really helps to bring that out. So there it is with the varnish. Looks much better that way.